So my project actually came out of the accreditation process for our department about 3 or 4 years ago when our department was under review for accreditation. During the student evaluation part, there was a discussion and a great deal of commentary from the recent grads or the current students that are seniors about the lack of scientific writing and scientific reading that was in the education of the curriculum in MCB. So this was turned into different projects and different things. We clearly have added a lot more of journal reading in all of the different classes. That's been added to all of the different upper division classes, both lecture and lab. And now I think what's really lacking is this understanding, of course, of better scientific writing. But part of my mandate from the department was to also improve scientific reading. So what I call is scientific literacy, this need to understand scientific writing and reading. And this is the kind of aspect here that students are transitioning from lab reports to writing up their own research finding. In MCB, we have about 70% of the students actually do independent research outside of the classroom. Probably about half of those are applying for grants and are trying to write up papers, presenting at lab meetings, all the different things that they need to learn as a scientist. So the students are expected to write these abstracts for their proposals, and they have no training in that. I see this again and again when you're trying to train the students, is that they don't know how to write that abstract, and yet we expect them, just because they can do an experiment, to be able to write an abstract, and that's just clearly not true. They clearly need the improvement in science comprehension as well as the practice of the scientific writing. So that's the idea. And many students have told me later on when they leave that the little bit that we do in the lab class that I teach is very helpful, and that they come back and request for it. So this is the kind of the basic scientific writing paper. This is very famous. I didn't come up with this. This is the kind of MRAD classic thing. And so this is, what we kind of are trying to get them to teach and to understand. This is what they do now. So instead of having this like introduction, they go from here to here, they just give this broad, vague introduction. They're like, oh, HIV is important and this is whatever. And I'm like, okay, get to the point. They don't really have a thing. They usually have a long method section. They have very little understanding of how to kind of have succinct, direct sentences in their methods. And then of course they have this very short results. This is what's happening. And this is really very common in the different honors theses that I read and help evaluate. And it's like the very end of their very last thing. Honors theses are due this week and RRR week. And this is the first time they've ever thought about how to write these things up. We want to get them practice earlier than that. And this is one of my main complaints that I try to emphasize again and again. 90% of their discussion is focused on everything that went wrong. They focus on the mistakes, they focus on what happened, and inevitably there's some like blame that happens where they're like, oh, the GSI gave us the wrong sample. It's just like constantly the thing. And I'm like, okay, no. Anyway, so I'm always saying, I don't think that was what happened, but this is what's going on. So part of what I'm trying to do is to teach what I call paper dissection and construction. The idea is to take breakdown and understand the sections of the paper, which in science and nature papers, they don't really understand the structure that there really is there. So we start with like simpler papers than they're doing. This idea here is to kind of have better understanding. And really, this is kind of like, Ryan helped me think about this more, about the fact that students have no concept of the fact that there's an iterative process in scientific writing, and that they come up with an idea, and it takes a long time to understand that what you originally thought was your purpose is going to change. And what you really originally thought was maybe what you're going to find in your results and your discussion, your impact, is going to change. And so I think that's what's really great. I mean, this even happens like during the semester in a lab class, where what we originally thought was going to be the purpose, can often end up being something else. And so, really this is the other aspect too, that a lot of them don't understand that you might end up writing up your results and then realizing you need to do another experiment in your data. And so I was teaching this in a freshman seminar, in a senior seminar, and a lot of students are like, what, I have all my data. And I'm like, yeah, but you see there's these holes in your story. And I think that's what's really important. It's okay. Once you put your data together, you realize that you need to do another experiment. And that's often the way it is. So this kind of like iterative process, and I really think they don't get this introduction discussion relationship. This has really been an important thing that we all have to learn, is that once you write an introduction, it has to relate back to what you're going to bring up in the discussion and vice versa. So the goal is to incorporate activities and exercises into the class, help train the GSIs with these exercise activities. Instead of doing this just on a seminar basis, my department's like, oh, you do not have time to teach seminars to a number of different people. We do not want you to do this. We're not going to have this done. But incorporating this to existing lab classes is where I'm at. So I'm going to try to use lab reports as writing practice. I was just talking about this with Robin. We all agree that lab reports could use some improvement in all of the laboratory classes at MCP. So outcomes and benefits. Hopefully the idea will be improved both reading and writing in scientific papers. I've already seen this with the seminar. Hopefully we'll see this with the lab classes. A better understanding of the science of publication review process. A lot of students have really difficulty understanding this kind of level of the types of journals. Now that there's like so many journals, it's very hard to comprehend this to the students, and they don't really understand that, so I teach some of that. And practice for future careers in scientific research. That is the main goal that everyone in the department will agree on. That is an easy thing. And that is it. Okay, thanks.